Welcome to Innovation Insights. This is a video series where we talk about the world of innovation. And today we're discussing the role of artificial intelligence and the transformation of the architecture, engineering, and construction industry. Joining me today is Stantec's Chief Technology Officer, Shankar Kalyana. Shankar, welcome.
Thank you, Mike. And thanks for hosting me here.
Well, you have a multi-decade career in technology, so you have a lot of expertise and knowledge in the area. So I'm curious, what was your first exposure to artificial intelligence?
The first one that captured not just my imagination, but also the public imagination is Deep Blue, when it beat Garry Kasparov in 1997. And then I guess the next seminal moment was when it was Watson, winning the Jeopardy competition. And I think the rest is history, because I think that really captured the public imagination, and that to me is kind of what got a lot of us in this space, you know, really excited about the promise of this technology.
So now that captured the general public's imagination, but why do you think AI can be so transformative for the AEC industry?
How it's able to both handle mundane and the complex, right? How it's able to not only deal with historical and the information, but also talk about predicting, you know, where we are able to go. Its ability to process vast amounts of data, and our ability to discern information and patterns and correlations that we normally would not be able to do as humans. I mean, it's just way beyond the ability of the human space to be able to do that, right?
Now, speaking of humans, yeah. So how do you successfully meld human knowledge with artificial intelligence technology to benefit our clients?
The value of the human input is extraordinarily important. Same thing with the quality and the veracity of the data. And eventually, you know, across the life cycle, as we go through continuous learning and adaptation and improvement of the model, as much as the AI can, you know, self-learn, I think the ability for us to meld that human intelligence into it, you know, greatly enhances both the effectiveness and the explainability and the accuracy of the models, as we go through.
Now, artificial intelligence is a very heady topic, and there are many layers, right? So a lot of employees and clients may be not well-versed in those technologies. So what techniques do you suggest to help bridge that gap?
Learning the fundamentals of what this technology is, you know, whether it's around AI 101, you know, what is generative AI 101, or what is supervised machine learning, you know, how is that different than unsupervised learning? And so on and so forth, including even some of the core technologies, you know, whether it's PyTorch, whether it's scikit-learn. I think, you know, it's important to be aware of these things, and obviously depending on the persona, you know, a CEO or a C-suite may have different expectations of learning and awareness compared to, say, a developer, you know, who's actually engaged in it.
One word you've used many times during this conversation, data, right?
Yeah.
So what exactly is the importance of data when it comes to artificial intelligence?
Yeah, artificial intelligence, regardless of the techniques that we use, sits on a foundation of data. I mean, fundamentally, it's garbage in, garbage out, right? So, you know, if we don't have the right context data, the right type of data, the right amounts of data, the right quality of data that is actually governed and so on and so forth, the data pipelines and having them ready is like so important in this endeavor.
Such thing as too much? Like, is there a Goldilocks zone in terms of data? You don't want too little, but you don't want too much. Is there a concern?
Yeah, that's a great question. Philosophically, too much of everything or anything, you know, tends to be interesting. But I would say, yeah, actually there is a pattern in the artificial intelligence world about what we call overfitting, right? When there is just too much data. And what we mean by too much data is not quantity of data, it's the type of data. When you have too much noise in there or too many outliers.
What is your prediction for the future when it comes to AI?
So there's going to be a tremendous amount of development in the technology sphere, whether it's around explainable AI, whether it's around super intelligence and general AI, whether it's around integrating artificial intelligence with other new technologies such as quantum computing for crypto. The possibilities are just endless. We are going to broaden and deepen the types of use cases that I think we are going to use artificial intelligence for. So, for me, this is like, we are in this moment. This is a moment where this is going to stay. This is not there is some hype, hype about it at this stage, which is true with every technology of such caliber. But this is here to stay. For me and the industry, I think it's a transformative moment.
It's going to be an exciting time, Shankar. Thank
Absolutely.
You very much. Appreciate
Mike,
it.
Thank you. Appreciate it.